Hello, new China. Welcome to China Arising, a special event in collaboration with Travel Daily China and Accor to mark the reopening of China to the world. And I just had lunch with Charlie. And you know, I was feeling really sorry for myself the last 2 years. And we thought about how we were trying to bring wit back from 50 people in 2020 to 250 people in 2021, and then last year, finally, we could go back to a 400-plus event. And I thought we had it tough. But what Charlie told me at lunch, and how he and his team of 18 had to spend almost 48 days in Shanghai in lockdown, because he couldn't go back to Guangzhou, which was in lockdown. And he was caught in this zone called the Twilight Zone. And finally, he managed to hold his event in December last year. So Charlie, you are a fighter. I take my hat off to you. The industry needs more people like you. Please. You know, it was almost exactly a year ago too, when we held our Asia Arising event to mark the reopening of Southeast Asia. And as it turned out, I was the only one who could not be at the event because guess what? I caught COVID after a trip to London. And I had to dial in virtually from my home in Singapore, and Eric Ngokfar of Klook had to go it solo on stage. I was so near and yet so far. And to think that we had to wait almost a year before our sisters and brothers in China could celebrate travel again, to be like us, almost a year before they could, like us, be free to travel again. And so I cannot overstate the significance of this moment. And I want to ask all of us in Singapore, from Singapore, I want all of us to give a big hand of applause to our Chinese brothers and sisters who've traveled to be with us. Can you stand up, please? Our Chinese brothers and sisters who are here with us, come to Singapore to mark this occasion of the reopening of China to the world. Let's welcome them back with open arms. So you know, at the Asia Arising event, all our speakers spoke of immediate spikes in travel, right? As soon as restrictions were lifted and air capacity restored. And I remember Eric saying, the travel bug is real. And he spoke of this immediate spikes in Klook's business as soon as borders were opened. Brent Anderson of Tourism Australia, he said, people are traveling for love first. And he spoke of the immediate comeback of visiting friends and relatives and students, with Singapore and India leading the charge back to Australia. And then we had Bertrand Saye from SCM Travel Solutions. He said, as soon as restrictions were lifted, business travel was off. And seems to me that similar trends are also happening for China, because people are also traveling first for love, students, friends and relatives, and then for business, like us here, like you. So according to Steve Sexton of McKinsey, whom I interviewed recently, business travel is leading the way in recovery, and leisure travel, he predicts, but who believes predictions these days, right? Because nobody gets it right. Nobody predicted that China would open so fast. Anyway, he predicts that leisure travel should follow by early summer. So at this point, I'd really like to thank our sponsors and partners for making this event happen. Nothing happens without your support and your faith in us. So for the purposes of this event, I also put together some data points from various sources, some from ChatGPT, some from humans. As they say, the best things happen when you blend human and machine together in the best possible way. So from ChatGPT, here's the way why the China market is so consequential to our world. Those are the numbers from ChatGPT. From McKinsey, the first slide, tracking the spike in air capacity seen right after opening. I think we got used to seeing all these squiggly lines during the pandemic, and we were just so happy to see the squiggly lines go up. And that's what happened, right? The second slide shows the recovery being led by Chinese carriers, clearly. They were ready to fly. From Atlas, which is an aggregator of low-cost and domestic airline content, based on data from major OTAs like Ctrip, Trip.com, China, and Fliji, we have the first slide showing what happened to flight searches for international tickets, both inbound and outbound, doubling immediately. And this slide showing searches for international flights by destination. 2 weeks after reopening, Bangkok, Hong Kong, Seoul, Singapore, and Macau. And 8 weeks after reopening, pretty much the same four, but Tokyo replacing Macau as the fifth. So recovery is dependent, of course, on capacity. And so I also asked aviation analyst Brendan Sobey to track the buildup of air capacity between China and Singapore up to mid-March. And here's the summary. 19 destinations in March 2023 versus 30 in March 2019. China-Singapore capacity at 43% right now. 150 flights between Singapore and China this week. So 9 Chinese airlines with 2 Singapore airlines versus 400 flights in March 2019. And the SIA group is targeting 80 to 90% capacity restoration by end of August. So really good news. Everything's on the right track. And we'll hear later from Kelvin Chan, Chief Commercial Officer of Scoot, who will be joining us on the panel later. So anyway, I hope that gave you a good overview of market trends as we dive deeper into the discussion. So